Daily Devotion with Pastor Balla for June 17, 2020, from Ruth, Chapter 3, The Redeemer. Naomi, hearing that Ruth captured Boaz's attention, was going to start playing matchmaker for Ruth. Naomi's reasoning was that Ruth was working very hard to sustain both of them. Let's pick it up with Chapter 3, verse 1. Then Naomi, her mother-in-law, said to her, "My daughter, should I not seek rest for you, that it may be well with you?" Naomi's plan was for Ruth to visit Boaz after the work was done for the day. But Ruth had to prepare for this visit. Verse 3, "Wash therefore and anoint yourself, and put on your cloak, and go down to the threshing floor. But do not make yourself known to the man until he has finished eating and drinking." I guess the old cliche, "the secret to a man's heart is through his stomach," still applied back then. Wait until he is done with dinner. Verse 9, Boaz said, "Who are you?" And Ruth answered, "I am Ruth, your servant. Spread your wings over your servant, for you are a redeemer." In this simple statement, Ruth is inviting Boaz to marry her. Just as a husband protects his wife, Ruth is asking Boaz to spread his wings of protection over her. By the way, God uses the same illustration of a protecting wing for us. From the Psalms, Psalm chapter 91, verse 4, "He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler." The popular hymn "On Eagle's Wings" also names this promise from God. What would be Boaz's reaction? Ruth was a foreigner, and she was much younger. But Ruth also was a hard worker and virtuous as she continued to take care of her mother-in-law, Naomi. Boaz's reply, verse 11, "And now, my daughter, do not fear. I will do for you all that you ask, for all my fellow townsmen know that you are a worthy woman. And now it is true that I am a redeemer, yet there is a redeemer nearer than I." What is meant by a redeemer? Jesus is our redeemer, in that Jesus buys us back from the devil. The cost was his innocent blood and death on the cross. During the time of Ruth, the land belonged to the family. But after Naomi and her husband left, and then her husband and her sons died without leaving any male heir to inherit the land, the nearest relative could buy it and should buy it. But along with the land comes Naomi and Ruth. The buyer of the land would need to produce an offspring for Naomi's late husband to continue the inheritance. So this was going to be a bit more complicated. However, Boaz said that he would be that redeemer after checking with the closer redeemer first. Ruth then returns to Naomi. Verse 16, "And when she came to her mother-in-law, she said, 'How did you fare, my daughter?' Then she told her all that the man had done for her, saying, 'These 6 measures of barley he gave to me, for he said to me, "You must not go back empty-handed to your mother-in-law." This was indeed a generous gift, but the best gift is yet to come." Join me again tomorrow as we find out about that best gift that is yet to come. God's peace and many blessings be with you. Thank you for watching, and please take an opportunity to share this video with others. If you have enjoyed these daily devotions, please consider making a donation to Peace Lutheran Church, 24024 West Main Street, Plainfield, Illinois, 60544. Thank you again for watching.